Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'll be sharing with you how I made this delicious peppered gizzard. So here are the gizzards I'll be using. They are very little. These are the ones I have left at home.
I have red pepper. Here is the main chili pepper for it. This pepper is very spicy, so I'm definitely going to use half, not all. Here I have my onion. Here I have some clove of garlic. Tomato half also. Then I'm just going to use a bit of puree tomato. It's not really compulsory, you can skip it, but I like using it. Like my mangi, my stock cube too. I'm using half. So basically all I'll be using now, I'm going to prep my gizzard and season it to parboil on the gas. So let's get started.
So let me season the gizzard now. I'm just going to add in a bit of salt. I don't love salt too much. And like I said, half stock cube. I'm going to go in with a bit of black pepper. This is optional. Also a bit of curry. Now I'm going to pour in a little water to steam it. Oh, and a bit of onion. So next I'm going to put on fire to cook for at least 30 to 45 minutes. So as the gizzard is boiling, I just diced up my tomato, bell pepper, garlic, a bit of onion. I don't like onion. Chili pepper and my tomato puree. That one is optional, like I said, you don't have to use tomato puree. So after about 45 minutes, the gizzard is ready. It is soft. That's how me and my husband actually like it, very soft. Now I'm just going to go ahead and fry the sauce for the gizzard. So I'm just going to put a pot on fire and add in some amount of oil. You could use extra virgin olive oil or vegetable oil, whichever oil you have or you like to use. So when the oil is a bit hot, just put in your diced onion to stir fry them and your garlic, diced garlic. Next, I'm just going to go in into all the diced vegetables. Next, I will just add a bit of puree tomato. Like I told you guys, this is optional. You don't have to use it if you don't want to. Oh, here I have extra onion that I blended, so I'm just adding it. Stir everything together. Now cover to cook for about 5 to 7 minutes. So after about 7 minutes, I'm just going to add in my steamed gizzard now. I'm going to add in a bit of salt to taste, half stock cube, a bit of black pepper, a bit of curry. So I'm just going to stir everything together. I can perceive it, and it is really spicy, just the way I wanted it. Now we just cover to cook for another 7 to 10 minutes. So guys, this is it. After about 7 minutes, it is ready, and this tasted so good. You can actually have this with white rice, yam, plantain, or just whatever you want to have it with, and it was spicy. You know, I told you I wanted it spicy, so it is spicy gizzard. So guys, we have actually come to the end of this video. I do hope you find this recipe helpful. Please, if you do, don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel, and I will see you all in my next video. Thank you. Bye.